Hello, YouTube friends. Welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here, I hope you subscribe. I've actually recorded this video about 3 weeks in advance just because I'm getting ready to take a vacation with family. We're going to go do a big 3 week long almost camping trip out west to Montana. So I'm very excited about that. So while you're watching this, I'm in Montana having a good time with my family. This is the second Friday of the month, and so that means we are doing the quilt block of the month, the journal quilt block of the month. How do we say that? I don't even know. But anyway, this is the seventh one, so we are now over halfway through with our quilt blocks. And in keeping with July and freedom and the 4th of July, all of that, we're going to do a little liberty block, and we are going to do it using a technique of foundation paper piecing. If you've never done it before, please don't be scared or turned off by the fact that it's not regular quilting, as you may know quilting. This is a really easy project. It's going to go quickly, and I'm going to give you really good instructions on how to do it. And I'm also going to provide you with the pattern so that you can do it with all the necessities that you need. All you need to do is go over to my Facebook page, Heidi Creates 1965, and I'm going, just drop me a line there. And if you don't want to leave your email there, that's fine. Just say, Heidi, I'd like to get the pattern for this, and make sure you specify that's July's block of the month. I will send you the PDF so that you can do this pattern. So let's go ahead and get started. I'll see you on the other side. This, like I said, this is a foundation paper piecing. If you've never done it before, this is going to be really, really simple. Not a lot of pieces. A couple of things that you need to decide. First of all, this may look a little bit different than the one that you get, just because I have solid lines on the very outside. Yours are going to be dotted lines, and those are your cutting lines. You have to decide how you want to do yours. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pieces that go to the star. You have to decide if you want your star to be different colors, or if, like mine, you want your star to be one color and all the pieces around it different colors, or the same color. Just obviously needs to be different from the star. All right, so once you've made that decision, then we need to cut our pieces apart. And let me just explain first how I've did this numbering system. Okay, you will notice, I'll turn this so that you can read it this way. You will notice that each of these four pieces is numbered 1 to 3, except for this one's 1 to 2. They have a letter in front of them. So here's how it goes. If you've never done foundation piecing before, when you start putting together the particular shape, you're always going to start with the number 1 and the number 2. Those are going to be your first pieces that you put down together. And then go from there numerically. What I have done is I've also alphabetized these so that once you have each of your four pieces put together, then you're going to put those together based on alphabetical. So that you would put A and B together first, then add C, and then add D. I'm trying to make it really simple so you can follow 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we are going to actually cut out our shapes and, you know, leave like, I don't know, 1/4 inch, 3/8 inch outside your dotted line that you have on your particular piece of paper. Mine, again, is the solid line. And I'm going to do that for all four of these pieces. I'm going to cut them out and come back. All right, once you have all your pieces cut out, then it's a matter of all the sew lines, and this is another thing you're going to notice on yours. There's some sew lines that extend past this first shape line on yours, and that means those are lines that you do want to sew exactly how they are outside the line. Right here, where these two lines meet, there is no extension of this line right here, and you do not want to go any further than that line right there. Okay, so to prep our pieces, if you have an add a quarter ruler, then you can just go to your pieces and on the lines, on the sew lines, you just bend your paper up and give it a crease. And that just helps for later on when you go to fold that back. If you don't have an add a ruler, then you're going to want to use something that is thin but stiff. Or I have like also these little pieces of cardboard. Those are great. They work as well. Just get them on that line and bend it up. Okay, here's another option. You don't have to use that. You don't have to fold it. You can actually use a ruler. Here's a ruler. This is the normal ruler. And using something soft, I'm going to use my wool mat. You can also use a tracing wheel. A tracing wheel or something like that. And then you can, on something that's softer so that you can actually puncture through the paper, is roll right on that line as well with your rotary tool. So hopefully I've given you some choices and you've got something that'll work for you. I'm going to go ahead and go through all of my pieces, get them folded, and I'm just going to use my add a quarter ruler. Now, if you haven't seen an add a quarter ruler, if you look, see if I can get that lined up right. If you look at the end of the ruler, you're going to see there is a little notch right in there. And that notch is so that when we go to cut our fabric and leaving a quarter inch, I'll show you how we use that so that you can do that very thing. Something else that is very helpful, arrange your pieces so you know which order that they go, you know, how they go together. And then, and you could have done this even before you cut these out, is actually either use pen, markers, color crayons, or just a pencil. But you're going to want to write in the color for each shape. That way there's just no confusion. You know exactly what you have to do. All my star pieces are white. So I got those marked, and then I think what I'll do is do blue, and then on these, I don't really care which reds I use, just as long as I'm using one of the versions of red. Okay, so I've marked all these for my colors, good to go. And it doesn't really matter which one you start with, because they're all going to get done. It only matters when you go to sew each of these together. But just for accuracy's sake, let's just start with 1A and 2A. All right, so I'm going to just say right now, it's better to cut more fabric than to cut too little, because there's nothing more frustrating than when you've sewn something on to your paper piecing and then have it be too small and you can't use it. And let's just avoid frustration. So a light box is also really great to use, because you can actually see your shape. But I'm going to go ahead. I do need to press these real quick. I think I failed to show you my fabric choices. I don't like to be too literal. These are not actual 4th of July fabrics, but obviously you can tell that they are actually in the colors of our flag. So I'm going to be actually doing my star in this white fabric with the flower print on it. And then each of these three reds will go in there, as well as the blue will go in twice. So I'm going to go ahead, and when you're doing something really small, you don't necessarily want to use something in a large print, unless there's something specific, you know, you're like fussy cutting and you really want something specific to look a certain way, then obviously there's no big hard fast rules. Just sometimes it's a good rule, but not always has to be the rule. So I'm going to press my fabric here. So this first piece, my white does not have to be, so you can see I have quarter inch lines, and you want to make sure you have plenty of fabric so that you can leave a quarter of an inch around your piece. So I can see my piece there, and that's plenty big. And then I'm going to be using a red on the 2A. All right, I'm going to use this red. I'm just going to go ahead and fold this back because this then shows the line for my red fabric. And again, leave plenty because you're going to need to use, you know, need to have that quarter inch, and it's just better to have more than enough than otherwise. Okay, so since number two is the larger piece, I just want it to hold still for me, but I'm going to actually be doing it from the wrong side. So I've got it positioned, all my quarter inch lines are completely covered by fabric. So what I'm going to do is just take, and I'm just using this washable glue stick. It does not gum up your needle, and it comes off very easily when you take the paper out. But it just holds everything in place to begin with, which is very nice. Okay, this is where we use add a quarter ruler or just your regular ruler. But we're going to fold that paper back on that line that I have. Okay. And then that notch lays right up against that fold of that fabric. Okay. And then I'm just going to go ahead and cut right across there, and that adds in the quarter inch that I need for a seam allowance. So now I'm just going to turn this and hold my other fabric, my white fabric, and again I can see my quarter inch line, so I have to make sure my fabric goes past that and goes past on the other side as well. So one thing that's good to do if you're doubtful, now see, that's going to be off. And I think I cut my fabric the wrong way. I should have put it upside down, actually. I'm going to try this way. This should work. And there we go. And that should cover that piece just fine. Yep. Okay. So I just had the wrong edge up against there. Those are all things you have to take note of. All right. So I have my quarter inch, my fabric's lined up. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up my paper. And on your particular paper, your lines will extend past the outer border. Not the dotted line, but the outer border. Okay, and I am going to sew across going past that line on both ends just to make sure that we have a good solid stitch. I have it lined up to sew straight down this line. I am back a little bit. And my sewing machine is set at a 1.5 millimeter stitch length. That helps to perforate the paper and also helps the stitches from coming undone so easily. I also have a 9014 needle, and I think that's, and a straight stitch, so make sure I said that. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started sewing straight down that line. That line is my stitch line. And I'm going to go extend past the black line a little bit. I've sewn on this line right here. And then when I turn this over, I'm just going to finger press. So I just finger pressed that fabric to one side. And I can tell with the light behind there, my pieces are both completely covered. So that's good. Now before I trim my pieces to the quarter inch, and yours will be the dotted line again, I'm going to trim this all the way down to the quarter inch line. I am going to press this first. And I'm not using any steam because I don't want my paper to crinkle up on me. And then for this, I'm just using my regular little ruler here. This is a Cute Cuts. And then just right on that quarter inch line, and again, yours will be the dotted line. Just cutting right across there, trimming it down to a quarter of an inch. And it's always good to make sure your pieces are all lying down flat, nothing folded under, because then you'd have to start all over again. So again, just give you a peek at what it looks like from the back side on the fabric. All right, looks good. Time to do the second one. So we have number two. This one starts with white and red again. So we're going to do, I'm going to be doing a different red this time. Just get my little triangle for the blue, for the white done here. I'm just going to take this piece right here. Okay, this is actually the back side of this fabric. I got it there. Kind of reminded me of fireworks. All right, fold that back. And just grab on the back of the number two, just because it is the larger of the two pieces. Okay. All right, now fold this back on the line between one and two. And just remember, this number one piece is very small. So I'm just wanting to put the fabric right sides together, and then bring that out and take it to the sewing machine. One of the things you want to be really careful of is as you're getting your fabric and your paper moved underneath there, is that nothing gets folded or shifted. So just make sure you check it periodically before you sew is always a good idea. I'm actually wanting to start sewing from the outside of the shape in towards the center. I want to end on the point, and I'm starting outside. You'll have a line that extends. Go ahead and start sewing right on the line. And you can see the line ends right here. And I am going to sew right to the end of that line, and then I will back tack like two stitches just to absolutely make sure this does not come undone. Have the stitching done there, so I'm going to go ahead, turn it over, and I'm just going to finger press that fabric. All right, time for the third piece, and I'm going to fold that on this line here and bring that up. Do the add a quarter that. So my third piece is going to be my blue. To make sure piece is plenty big enough. Fold it back, the paper back, making sure to sew or to put your fabric right sides together. Now one of the things you want to pay attention to is the shape of your piece that you're putting out. The shape goes out straight here, but it sticks out here. So I want to make sure I put the excess fabric on that end more. And then go ahead and fold that back open. And we're going to stitch across that line, extending on either side of the outside border line.
Okay, turn that over and finger press that seam. Now before I trim that, I'm going to give it a quick iron without steam. All right, there is our trimmed piece. This one, I have white. All of them are white. Tend to try and put my fabric facing down. That way I'm cutting the shape correctly. Use this whole piece right here. And remember the quarter inch. You gotta make sure that it's at least as big as the quarter inch size. So I'm going to put the glue on number two, and should have that pretty good. And if you need to, you can pick it up and look at it through the light through it. Make sure you got the entire piece covered, and I do. Got my fabric facing the other, facing down, right face down. And you can use a pin too. If you don't have glue, you want to use a pin, you can go ahead and do that. All right, so let's do this piece over and do our add a quarter. And that will be this one. Right sides together. Open that back up and give it a sew. Again, I'm sewing past the shape lines on either side. Just a couple stitches is fine. Go ahead and finger press that open. And do number three, fold my on the line. I'm gonna redo that fold a little bit. It didn't fold enough. Okay. And we'll do our add a quarter seam allowance. Now, I cut this a little close right here, but it'll work because it's beyond my cut line, so that was cutting it close. All right, to take my next piece, and I'm actually going to give, let me see. I want to use it the long ways, so I want to give that edge nice and straight. Line. Okay, let's bring this back, just lining that up, right sides together, and open my paper back up and stitch on the line. Alright, I'll go ahead and finger press this open. And take it to my iron now and give that a good pressing. Alright, now again, that was just three white pieces. And you might say to yourself, well, why wouldn't you just make that one piece of white fabric? Well, for one thing, the shape of the star, it has these lines connecting all these legs to the main body of the star. And when it comes to, you know, foundation paper piecing, it's all about pieces creating a shape. And so I like the fact that there's three pieces creating this one shape right here. All right, got that one done. So I have two more to do. And these are going to be basically exactly what we've already done. I think you can handle these next two on your own. And when I get them done, we'll come back and I'll show you how to assemble the four pieces together. I thought I still had two pieces to do, but apparently I already did three on camera with you. I only had one to do. Anyway, I got them all four pieces done, and this is how they'll go together. Now, that's the fabric side. Now, if there's any question, you're confused about how it goes together, when you turn it over, you can look at the letters now on each of the pieces. We did all the numbers, now we're going to do the letters. So A and B are going to be joined together on their adjoining line here. Now, some people take their paper off at this point. Others like to leave it on, just adds more stability. But what you're going to do is you're going to see that there's going to be seams that will align. And you'll bring those seams together. Now, the way some of these go, it can be a little tricky as far as lining up the seams, because the seams line up a quarter of an inch down from the top. So if I were to bend that back there, those seams should be joining, which they are right there. And one of the ways to check to see if this is going to work out is to take a pin and hold it across your quarter inch line right there. And up here, where the two sides meet, that pin should be crossing over right where they meet. If they're not meeting, then you don't have it lined up right. So if one's too far down here, if the top one's too far down, adjust a V of the two fabrics should be right there where that pin crosses. So I got the right sides together, papers on the outside. I'm going to go ahead and do the quarter inch seam allowance all the way from the edge of the fabric to edge of fabric. Open that up. Yeah, that always makes me so happy. So you can see my seams joined up perfectly right there, and we're lined up perfectly right there. I'm lined up perfectly right there. Okay, we'll get the next one now. We have A and B. Now it's time for section C. Now, because I have the seam allowance, sewn, I'm going to tear away just the seam allowance part, just so that it makes it easier for me to press open that seam allowance. Because these seam allowances, now I'm going to be pressing open. That'll just make everything work out a little bit better. And just gently pull away, and the paper should rip fairly easily because it's been perforated by the needle. Okay, then I'm just finger pressing both directions with my fingers there. Yeah, when you finger press, you're using your fingers. Okay, all right, now I got that seam pressed open with my fingers. I'm going to go ahead and hit it with the iron. All right, you can see that I've got that pressed. So we have 3C, which we have A, B, now we need to do C. And again, we're going to be matching up these seams here. And we want them to match up so that when they cross down where the quarter inch line is, that's where they meet, if that makes sense. So if I hold it on the quarter inch line, and I bend my paper back just to take a peek, I got my seams matched up really well. I'm gonna check this one. Same thing, looks good. Now, if you just wanna make sure nothing shifts, you know, put a couple clips on there. So I'm gonna go ahead from end to end, do the quarter inch seam allowance. or last piece to do yet. Oh, I didn't even show you the other side. So yeah, I got my lines really good. Okay, last one. We have the 3D. And again, we just have to line up those seams right there where the star points come down into this fabric. Usually if you divide the difference up between the two when you're looking at it, where here it's small, here it's wide. The front one is narrower and the back one is wider. So if you divide the difference between the two, as far as matching up those seam allowances, it should work out. Right, I already tore away the seam allowance paper, and now that I have the block all done, and there you go, you can see that, and the seams came out so nice and even, line up great. So now it's time to just tear off the rest of the paper, and this one you can see is pretty much coming off, and just pull away horizontally from, you know, just pull away from the stitch line, just gently. Don't get too crazy about it. Usually I do all the large pieces first. All right, and then the smaller ones, if you need to, use a little like seam ripper or something like that so you can get under the paper. And then just pull that away gently. Now remember, some of these might have a little glue on them, but they do come off pretty easily. Just a little extra tiny bit. Now, there are other ways to do this. You could be using freezer paper, and where you're using the same paper over and over again, you never have to tear it away. You might want to look into that. Okay, I have put my quilt sandwich together, have my block on the top, my quilt batting, I'm using 100% cotton, I think it's called Warm and Natural, and then my backing fabric. So I am just going to do a little stitching here with the sewing machine. I think what I want to do is, I think I want to do a blanket stitch on that star, just kind of give it a little bit of a homegrown look. Blanket stitch done all the way around. You can do that by hand or sewing machine if you have that particular stitch. I am going to go ahead now and trim this block so that it is 5 inches square. And I'm going to go ahead and bind this. So basically what I'm doing is I see 5 inches and I'm centering my block. So that I'm taking about the same amount off from either side. There is the block all squared up to 5 inches square. And I'm just going to go ahead and bind this. I'm going to do I don't know. Maybe I'll do white. I'm not sure. No, I think I'll do red. I'll go ahead and do a red binding and then show you that once I have it all done.
First thing I want to say is I reserve the right to change my mind. As you can see, I did that. I said I was going to do a red binding on here and I didn't. I used blue. I don't know, for some reason, I felt like it needed a dark border around all of this. Really draws your eye into the star. Anyway, this is a completed block for July. Just to talk a little bit about what I did there. One of the things I did on this, I've got little threads everywhere. One of the things that I did that I kind of liked was I decided to do a lighter thread for the binding when I sewed it on. Just because I wanted, I don't know, that kind of that country feel. I hope you enjoy that. And I really, if you've never tried foundation paper piecing, I really hope you give this a try. It's a really, it's an easy project to start out with. And in the future, I will be having patterns available that you can purchase and really stretch your skills with the foundation paper piecing. If you make the block, I would love it if you would post pictures of your block over on Instagram. Just do hashtag 12 Heidi Creates, and then if you're on Facebook, go to Heidi Creates 1965 and share your photos there as well. I hope this finds you all happy, healthy, and enjoying your freedom. And until next time, have a great one. Bye for now. It's a great